Hello friends. So friends, we are going to continue with our discussion on goods and service tax. Right? Now, under goods and service tax, we were discussing about the taxable event. What is taxable event? The event on the occurrence of which your liability to pay tax arises. Now, what is the taxable event under GST? The taxable event under GST is supply. Supply of goods and services. Now, the question is, what is supply? It says supply includes. So, there are four inclusions to the term supply. Right? So, it is a very wide term. When it says supply includes, it becomes a very wide term. And in the last lecture, what we discussed was inclusion 1 for the definition of supply. I have divided this definition into 4 inclusions, right? So we discussed the inclusion 1. Let us quickly revise what we have discussed in the inclusion 1. Inclusion 1 says supply includes supply of both goods as well as services, right? That is the basic of goods and service tax, that all the goods and services have come under one tax, that is goods and service tax. The terms like sale and purchase have been replaced by the term supply under GST. Supply being a very wide term, therefore includes sale, transfer, barter, exchange, license, rental, lease or disposal. So in the earlier acts, we used to use these words like sale, transfer, barter, but all these words under GST have been replaced by a single word, that is supply. Clear? Then I told you supply includes supply of goods and services made or agreed to be made, right? Made or agreed to be made. Supply includes supply of goods and services as well as an agreement to supply goods and services in the future. That is, the future transactions are also included. Why these transactions have been included? So that if there is any advance received against that agreement to supply in the future, that advance is taxable as GST as soon as it is received, right? For example, on 20th of July, A agrees to supply goods to B in August 2017. B pays 10,000 as advance to A for supply to be made in August. Now, as per the definition of supply, advance received against agreement to supply goods in the future will attract GST, right? So this was the main aim of adding these words, agreed to be made. To tax any future transactions, to tax any advance received against the future transactions. Clear? Then it says, for a consideration. The consideration means something in return. The price paid by one party, right, for the promise of other. Right, A promises to supply goods to B. B in return will pay 10,000 for the goods. So the consideration in this case is 10,000. That is, one person promises to do some act and the other person promises to pay for that act. Clear? Then consideration can be of two types, monetary and non-monetary. Monetary consideration is where you pay in cash, where you pay in the money terms, right? Like A agrees to supply goods to B and B in return will pay 10,000. Something in the money terms, that is a monetary consideration. And what is a non-monetary consideration? Where something paid in return is not in money terms. A agrees to dry clean B's clothes and B agrees to click A's photograph. That is a non-monetary consideration. Now the question was whether non-monetary consideration is taxable under GST. Yes, the non-monetary consideration also needs to be valued for determining tax payable under GST. Clear? And how to value that, we will see in the later sessions also, where we'll do the valuation, right? Then activities without any consideration like donations, gifts or free charities are outside the ambit of GST. But at this clause, I told you one thing, that there is an exception to this clause, right? We'll discuss the exceptions in the later sessions. There are exceptions to this clause, right? Then it says supply must be made by a person defined in section 284 of the CGST Act. Section 2, subsection 84 of the CGST Act. Almost the definition is similar to what is given in the Income Tax Act. Clear? Then supply in the course or furtherance of business. That is, the supply must be made for the business or for expansion of business. Clear? For the furtherance of business, that is for increasing your business, only then it will be considered as supply. Right? So this is inclusion number one. Now what we are going to discuss is, we are going to discuss inclusion number two. Now, what is inclusion number two? Inclusion number two is related to import of services. Import of services. Now, if we talk about this, I have again divided this inclusion into various parts. Right? Import of services, the first part here is import. Import of services. That is, you are taking the services from outside your country, from outside India. A is residing in India, and there is a person B who's residing in USA. Now A has taken the services of B. A has taken the IT services of B. That is import of services. Right? If we are taking the service from outside our country, that is import of service. Now second important point here is, consideration must be paid. Consideration must be paid. So the inclusion to say is, supply includes import of services where consideration must be paid. For example, A is in India, B is in USA. A has taken the services of B, that is import of service. Right? And for this import, A pays to B rupees 2 lakhs. Right? A ने services import की और उन services के लिए A ने B को pay किया 2 lakh. So it says consideration must be paid. Only then it will be considered as supply. Import of services where consideration must be paid. अगर A ने ये services free में avail की होती, then it should not be supply. अगर A ने 2 लाख रुपीस नहीं पे किए होते, A ने फ्री में ये सर्विस ली होती B से, then it would not have come under the definition of supply. Clear? it would not have come under the definition of supply inclusion 2. Clear? Now, third part of this inclusion. Third part says, it is not relevant whether services are taken for business or for personal use. So ये इंक्लूजन क्या कह रही है कि आपने सर्विसेज इंपोर्ट की, आपने आउट ऑफ कंट्री किसी से सर्विसेज ली, उसके लिए कंसिडरेशन पे किया, राइट, उसके लिए कुछ ना कुछ अमाउंट पे की, लेकिन ये जरूरी नहीं है कि वो सर्विसेज आपने अपने बिजनेस के लिए ही ली. अगर आपने अपने पर्सनल यूज के लिए भी अगर वो सर्विसेज इंपोर्ट की हैं, आपने उसके लिए कंसिडरेशन पे की है, देन इट विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज सप्लाई. Clear? So the third part says it is not relevant whether services are taken for business or for personal use. Right? Example le lete. A India mein hai aur B jo hai wo USA mein hai. ए ने बी की सर्विसेज ली. किस तरह की सर्विसेज? आर्किटेक्चर सर्विसेज. ए ने आर्किटेक्ट सर्विसेज ली बी की. क्लियर? अब पॉइंट ये है कि जो आर्किटेक्ट की उन्होंने सर्विसेज ली हैं वो किस पर्पस के लिए ली हैं. वो दो पर्पस के लिए हो सकती हैं. या तो वो पर्सनल यूज के लिए, अपने घर के आर्किटेक्चर के लिए, बी ए का रिलेटिव है, राइट, तो ए ने क्या किया, ये सर्विस ली अपने पर्सनल यूज के लिए, अपने घर के आर्किटेक्चर के लिए. दूसरा हो सकता है कि उन्होंने अपने ऑफिस के आर्किटेक्चर के लिए की बी की सर्विसेज, राइट. अब उसके बाद एक पॉइंट आ रहा है, अगर पर्सनल यूज के लिए की है तो कंसिडरेशन पे किया या नहीं की? कंसिडरेशन पेड और कंसिडरेशन नॉट पेड. सिमिलरली अगर ऑफिस के लिए ली है, अगेन दो पार्ट्स, कंसिडरेशन पेड और कंसिडरेशन नॉट पेड, राइट. या तो कंसिडरेशन पे की होगी या नहीं की होगी. क्लियर? ए ने बी से आर्किटेक्ट सर्विसेज हायर की, यूएसए से इंपोर्ट की सर्विसेज. अब जो आर्किटेक्ट की सर्विसेज ली है वो दो कारण से हो सकती है, या तो वो पर्सनल रीजन से हो सकती है या ऑफिस के लिए. उन्होंने अपने घर का आर्किटेक्चर करवाना था तो उसके लिए बी की सर्विसेज ली, या उन्होंने ऑफिस का आर्किटेक्चर करवाना था उसके लिए बी की सर्विसेज ली. उसके बाद क्वेश्चन आता है कि अगर पर्सनल यूज के लिए की, क्या उन्होंने कोई कंसिडरेशन पे की, क्या उनको मनी पे की कोई, या कंसिडरेशन नहीं पे की. सिमिलरली ऑफिस के लिए उन्होंने कंसिडरेशन पे की या कंसिडरेशन पे नहीं की. अब इनमें से कौन सी चीज सप्लाई मानी जाएगी और कौन सी सप्लाई नहीं मानी जाएगी एज पर इंक्लूजन टू. इंक्लूजन टू कहता है कंसिडरेशन पे करनी बहुत जरूरी है, चाहे आप बिजनेस के लिए कर रहे हो चाहे आप पर्सनल यूज के लिए कर रहे हो. तो अगर कंसिडरेशन पे की है तो क्या वो सप्लाई है? यस. अगर कंसिडरेशन नहीं पे की तो क्या वो सप्लाई है? नो. क्योंकि इंक्लूजन टू में कहा है कि द पेमेंट ऑफ कंसिडरेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वेदर इट इज फॉर द पर्सनल यूज और फॉर द ऑफिस यूज. अगर ऑफिस यूज के लिए किया, कंसिडरेशन पे की, क्या ये सप्लाई है? यस अगर कंसिडरेशन नहीं पे की क्या यह सप्लाई है नो सो वॉट इज इंपॉर्टेंट इज द पेमेंट ऑफ कंसिडरेशन चाहे आप सर्विसेज इंपोर्ट कर रहे हो पर्सनल यूज के लिए चाहे आप ऑफिस यूज के लिए द पेमेंट ऑफ कंसिडरेशन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट अगर कंसिडरेशन पे की है तब भी वो आपकी सप्लाई मानी जाएगी अदरवाइज सप्लाई नहीं मानी जाएगी क्लियर सो दिस इज इंक्लूजन टू टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सप्लाई विच सेज इंपोर्ट ऑफ सर्विसेज वेयर कंसिडरेशन इज पेड whether the services are taken for personal use or for the business use. Clear? So this is all about the inclusion to under supply, that is import of services, right? Where the consideration must be paid, but it is not relevant whether services are taken for business or for personal use. Right? एग्जाम्पल आपको एक्सप्लेन कर दी आई होप दिस मच इज क्लियर राइट सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट इंक्लूजन टू सो हमने इंक्लूजन वन भी कवर कर ली इंक्लूजन टू भी कवर कर ली अब नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में हम करेंगे इंक्लूजन थ्री ऑफ सप्लाई क्लियर So friends, if you have any queries, just send me an email at ksjteaching@gmail.com. Right? So that's all for this lecture, friends. Thank you so much.